Isn't it amazing what we can do with paper? We can use it for making a remarkable piece of painting, or maybe just writing down our feelings in a diary. But I'm not here to tell you about how we use paper. That would be pretty boring. Why I'm here is what you will figure out in the next few minutes. Now, how many of you have at least thought once in your life, I should try saving paper? And how many of you have gone back to meh, I'll just buy more paper? As a child, I always knew the worth of things. Like my sister would just be relaxing and watching TV, and I would just walk in like a little devil. Now just turn off the TV. And as every typical sister shooted at me and say, "Hey, are you crazy?" And I would say, "No important person was watching TV. Why waste electricity?" Now you know why elder siblings hate younger siblings. So coming back to the life of a ninth grader, things got a little bit more serious. And so I was studying for my maths exam and suddenly I ran out of paper. And so in my imaginative mind, I'm on the set of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. And Amitabh Ji is sitting in front of me and he says, "You have run out of paper. Here are your options. Option A, find space on other pages. Option B, buy more paper. Option C, procrastinate. Option D, annoy your siblings." For me, I naturally chose option A, but then it hit me. Majority of the people, after procrastinating and annoying their siblings, tend to go ahead and buy more paper and throw away the paper they've just used once. Now this bothered me as I wondered what really happens to all the textbooks, notebooks, school assignments, exam papers after they're used. They end up in a landfill or get thrown into the ocean. And trust me and the boys have already wasted a lot of paper. If we sold all the paper we've used till date, we would be so rich even Elon Musk could feel shy. So I became curious and asked Google Baba, how is paper made? And he told me all they do is take wood, bash it up into a pulp in water, add some ink to it, lay it out, let it dry, and boom, paper. So again, do you think using up so many trees just for making something we'll use once is worth it? With so many trees cut down, the risk of global warming along with low levels of oxygen increase. And already with the destruction humans have done to the earth, this does really add a heavy blow. So, is there a simple way we can save the earth just by saving paper? So for now, pretend this problem never exists. We all love food, right? North Indian, South Indian, Pani Puri, Vada Pav. But food tastes best if it's made at home. With that being said, Akshay Kumar has a saying, and it goes like this. Bharatiya mahila bhi badi ajeeb hoti hai. Raat ka bacha hua khana wo subah tadka maar ke wapas paros deti hai. For some of you who didn't understand that, and Akshay Kumar is saying that Indian women are geniuses. And at last night's leftovers, they serve it as breakfast after adding some spice to it. Not gonna lie, that is pretty genius. So, coming back to recycling paper situation, we can take inspiration from our genius moms. Here's how. Ladies and gentlemen, students of BRS, you can recycle paper at home. Here's how. All you really need is some used paper, a mixer, some water, a cloth to dry the pulp in, and possibly just a bit of patience. The process goes something like this. Take the used paper and water and put it in a mixer and make a thick pulp out of that. After that, optional, you can add some ink to it to change the color of the pulp. After that, add some water to it, lay it out on a cloth, drain out all the water, let it dry, and boom, paper. It is that simple. After this very simple 5-minute process, you can go about your daily routine. You know, eat, sleep, eat, sleep. Making paper was a very fun skill to learn, as it really didn't require much skill. In fact, it was so easy that I perfected it on my first try, which basically means that it's effortless to do. This idea is totally worth spreading, as it can literally be done by people who cannot afford to buy paper, or maybe just by people who want to save trees somehow. But it should especially be done by your students. As you know, we students get a lot of homework and assignments, but after those assignments are graded and returned, they're literally thrown here and there. It's as if the students don't care about it anymore. I myself have done that, but really didn't know what to do with it other than... So I told my idea to a lot of people, and not surprisingly, they told my idea wouldn't work out. And so, me being the jobless 14-year-old I was, I still went ahead and continued with my project. And to my surprise, I found out that recycled paper is just like virgin paper. You can even use it for making origami or even for writing notes. I'd really recommend you all try this, as it can literally save tons of trees from being cut down. As a matter of fact, every year 4 billion trees are cut down, out of which 35% contribute to the paper making process. And after 14 years of education, if my math is right, that would mean 1.4 billion trees. That is 8 zeros, by the way. Yes, 1.4 billion trees are cut down every year just for making paper. And if you take this very simple step to recycle paper at home, we can hopefully bring down that 35%. As you do know, we do need trees now more than ever. Also, because colonizing Mars will take some time. I mean, can you believe you can prevent global warming, icebergs melting, rising sea levels, air pollution, and many more problems just by planting and saving trees? Now, doesn't that sound a bit too good to be true? Things that sound too good to be true don't usually happen. But this one can happen. This one can be a reality. Just imagine a world where all these problems do not exist and nature can truly be beautiful. We all have this inner desire to make the world a better place, a more beautiful place. Isn't that why we all have tried at least once to save the environment just by ourselves? Alone, this cannot be done. But together, we can make this dreamland a reality. And with that, I would like to conclude my speech by saying, recycling paper is not the solution to ending global warming, but it is a step forward. Thank you.